So let us make the restart, doctor. I hope we are clear in our voice and vision. Right? Is the voice okay? Just find out. Voice is okay? Alright. A young man smells the burnt wound and rubber. He turns the head and his upper body right makes chewing movements. Classical of partial complex seizures. Because of the involvement of the temporal lobe, there is olfactory hallucinations which will arise. A 52-year-old antipsychotic treated and develops pigmentation. Classical side effect of chlorpromazine is what need to be remembered. What is a delusion? Delusion basically involves the problem in the thought content is what need to be remembered. Illusion, delusion, hallucination, we need to know the differentiation. Now, paranoid schizophrenia, amphetamines are the ones which are typically associated. In leprosy, it is the posterior tibial nerve which is classically affected. Dr. Sunayan proposes an objection about why not, I'll take up your specific objection about conversion disorder at a later point, doctor. I mean, end of the discussion, we will definitely have a fight about the answers. Okay. Alright. What is the most common nerve which is affected in leprosy, as we already discussed? Now, coming to the leprosy, if you find the lesions on the buttocks, what does it indicate? It indicates borderline leprosy. Not lepromatous leprosy is what we have to basically appreciate. IP3, inositol triphosphate, is the secondary messenger for which adrenergic receptor? You know, alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. Alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. Isme kisko? IP3 is the secondary messenger. Who will give me the correct answer? Inositol triphosphate. Only for one, IP3 is the secondary messenger. Inositol triphosphate. Beta 2 is a proposal coming from Siri Shravya. No, Siri Shravya says alpha 2. Abhi Anjum says alpha 1, what is alpha 2 is a proposal from Shravani from Guntur, that's right. So doctor, have one amendment, H1, histamine 1, alpha 1, V1, M1, M3, for all of them IP3. And increased calcium is the secondary messenger. Beta 1, beta 2, H2, V2, D1, for all of them it is a cyclic AMP with the secondary messenger. This one favorite question of the examiner, which you are going to crack in the tomorrow's exam, and you will remember me that day. Now, coming to dermatophyte infections, typically where, which layer do they involve? Dermatophytes are the keratophilic fungi. They involve the keratinized tissue, and it is the stratum corneum which is the one which is basically invaded. Favus scholini, trichophyton scholini is need to be remembered. Dopamine, why do you give it to critically ill patients? Because it will improve the visceral blood flow is what need to be remembered. Now, if the end-diastolic pressure is held constant, what will lead to an increase in the cardiac index? First, you need to know what is this terminology is all about. Cardiac index is basically computed by dividing the cardiac output by the body surface area. Cardiac output is the product of stroke volume and heart rate. Now, stroke volume in turn is dependent upon the is the combination of the heart rate and stroke volume. So that is the reason any increase in the cardiac heart rate will increase the stroke volume, which will increase the cardiac index, is what need to be remembered. Now albumin is the one which is often assessed in the intensive care unit to know whether the patient is having sufficient nutritional supplementation and support or not, is what need to be remembered. Coming to pancreatic trauma, generally pancreatic trauma is very easy to manage. If you provide a drain, simple drainage, you can manage. But pancreas is a retroperitoneal organ. You have big vessels there. So the injury to those vessels leading to an exsanguinating hemorrhage is the underlying cause of the mortality, which you see in the case of the pancreatic injuries, is what need to be remembered. Now, whenever you want to detect a non-seminomatous testicular cancer's recurrence, it is the alpha fetoprotein which will help you to identify it. Why do you want to know about the estrogen receptor status? Typically, if you want to use an anti-estrogen to manipulate the tumor, then you need to know the estrogen receptor levels, is what need to be remembered. When you call primary hyperparathyroidism, calcium levels are a very important indicator. Serum calcium above 11 milligram per deciliter is considered to be one of the important indicators. Okay, doc. Should mean answer. Anti-muscarinic agent which will reduce the urgency and reduce the spasm of the bladder is which agent? Which anti-muscarinic we use to treat urge incontinence, basically to relax the detrusor? Who will give me the correct answer? One confident answer. Anti-muscarinic. Yes, doctor. Duloxetine is the Sunayan's proposal. Anything else? Duloxetine, even Anuja also seconds the Sunayan's proposal. So, doctor, remember what are anticholinergics we use. In the eye, we use atropine to produce mydriasis cycloplegia. Parkinsonism, we use benzotropine with anticholinergic properties. Scopolamine is anticholinergic used in motion sickness, and ipratropium in asthma, like atropine. Oxybutynin, glycopyrrolate in case of urge incontinence, and pyrangipine in the case of the peptic ulcer treatment. Anti-muscarinic agents is something which you have to have a very, very strong hold, is what need to be remembered. Now coming to the adrenocortical insufficiency, how to recognize it? Suppose you have done surgery, within hours of surgery somebody passed away. That's how you sometimes identify a untreated chronic adrenal insufficiency, because post-operatively you expect a good adrenal activity, so which is basically missing. Now 49-year-old, after biopsy, found to have a 1 centimeter breast mass, which is a comedo ductal carcinoma in situ. How do you want to manage? If it's a stage 1 breast cancer, what are the options for you, especially in the case of a premenopausal women? Lumpectomy combined with axillary lymph node dissection and adjuvant radiotherapy is one choice. Second is modified radical mastectomy is the other choice are available. Both of them are more or less equivalent in the cure, but the chances of the local recurrence with the lumpectomy, axillary dissection, radiation is typically slightly higher. So that is the reason we try to still advocate local excision with adjuvant radiation therapy, because it is still a stage 1, is what need to be remembered. Modified radical mastectomy was not given in the options. Now, 42-year-old with familial breast cancer showing ductal hyperplasia with atypia. Sisters, aunties, everybody had breast cancer. So what do you want to do with her? Generally, the chance with the familial breast cancer, the chance of risk of developing breast cancer is quite high. So that is the reason There are two options available. One is she can continue with the routine surveillance is indicated because the risk is high. In few subset of people, prophylactic simple mastectomy is indicated if they also have the BRCA1 gene positivity is the point of interest here. If you give cortisone in ITP, since it is an autoimmune destruction of platelets, platelet count will definitely improve. A 46-year-old with regurgitation with Birdwick means achalasia. Hence, the lower esophageal sphincteric pressure will be high. It fails to relax. Hence, there is a typical Birdwick deformity. Imperforate anus can be of two kinds. A high anal malformation or a low anal malformation. Always in relationship with lipotrani muscle. If it is a high malformation, you need to do all the way pull through procedure, and there the continence post procedure is doubtful. But it's a low malformation, prognosis relatively good is the point of interest. 45-year-old perforated peptic ulcer, 6 hours duration. Generally, if it is of a more than 12 hours old, there will be a lot of peritoneal soiling. Hence, we tend to not do definitive acid reducing procedure. But it being less than 12 hours, assuming less amount of soiling, and since already chronic peptic ulcer disease history is there, we want to do anthectomy, truncal vagotomy in the same sitting is what need to be appreciated. You found that there is a 4 centimeter metastasis with the hepatic flexure colon cancer. What do you want to do? Always, what is the rule in colon carcinoma? Whatever be the stage, however be the metastasis, you need to resect it and then create a colostomy. Why? Because to pass everyday motion, you require a path, no? So if the colon cancer is obstructing, it can lead to death. So you need to salvage it irrespective of its stage and the number of mets in the liver is the general rule, which is only applicable for the colon cancer. Putrid hematoma has no malignant potential. Coming to bronchial carcinoid, only rarely they produce the carcinoid syndrome. They don't frequently metastasize is the point of interest. Aspirin is a very, very effective antiplatelet agent.